Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can print these two patterns using C programming. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel by following this link, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my Android app based on programming, which is available on Google Play. Name is TechImage. Now coming on to the topic. First, you have to understand how this pattern will be displayed. So you can understand it by this pattern. Here you can see I have replaced space with hyphen. So in first row, 4 spaces and 1 digits are required. Then in second row, 3 spaces and 2 digits are required. Then 2 spaces and 3 digits. Then in fourth row, 1 space and 4 digits. And in fifth row, 0 space and 5 digits. So this way I have identified how many times space loop will repeat and how many times digit loop will repeat. So if we are talking about first row, if you want to print first row, then one loop will be required for space that will repeat 4 times, and second loop will repeat 1 time to print digits. Then to print second row, space loop will be repeating 3 times and digits loop will be repeating 2 times and so on. So now I have to implement a code in C to display this pattern. So two loops we have identified, one for space and one for digits, and one more loop will be required to print how many rows you want to display. So you can see here I have implemented first loop, that is starting from 1 and it will repeat n times, and value of n is received through printf and scanf. So this loop will repeat n times and it will control rows. When value of I will be 1, control will be transferred to this loop, which is j, and it will print spaces. So j is starting from 1. Suppose n is 5, we want to print 5 rows. So this condition is 5 minus I is 1 first time. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So this loop will repeat 4 times. So 4 spaces will be displayed. After termination of this j loop, control will be transferred to k loop. So j and k both are independent loops. When j will be terminated, then control will be transferred to k loop. K will print digits and it is repeating I times. So first time I is 1, it will repeat 1 times and I will be printed as value. So I is representing row number. So first time it is 1, so 1 will be displayed. Then after completion of k, new line will be displayed through slash n. Then control will be transferred to i++. This time I is 2. So second loop j will repeat n minus I. So n is 5, I is 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. So this time space loop will repeat 3 times and this k loop will repeat 2 times because I is 2, and I is 2, that's why 2 will be printed twice. This way all the digits will be displayed on console. So I am executing this code. I am entering 5 as number of rows and you can see the output. It is equivalent to this pattern which is required. Now we have to print its reverse order. So for that purpose, I am changing only I loop. It is starting from n. Its condition is I greater than equals to 1 and I minus minus. So this way I have changed the rotation cycle of I loop. It is starting from 1 and it is decremented to 1. Rest of the loops are same. So now again I am executing this code. I am entering 5. You can see the output and you can match it with the requirement. So here by changing in first loop, the reverse of the pattern is displayed properly. So this way I have implemented both the pattern in C programming with the help of nested loops. Here total 3 loops are required to print these two patterns. I hope you have understood the concept well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my YouTube channel through youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool URL. Thank you for watching this video.